The following broadcast has been inspired by the Joni Rotten Ministry of Health and Well-Being, where I can change to we can change illness to wellness. Many studies show that most perfumes, even in small amounts, can cause neurological disorders in the fetus of pregnant mothers. One of the causes of autism is exposure to chemicals, perfumes, and medications during pregnancy and after birth through breast milk. Let's take a look at this article from the Journal of Environmental Health Science and Engineering. And afterwards, we're going to see what the government of Canola Tardistan has to say about phthalates and whether or not they're safe, with a choice for us, the consumer. And here's a bit of a punchline. Keep away from children, last but not least. Before they give us the references of more information, keep away from children. Don't let a child suck or chew on soft plastic products that aren't intended for children, because these products that we'll see later on after we connect all these dots are in plastics, soft plastics. So think child products, soft plastics. Here is the most scary one of them all. Di-2-ethylhexyl phthalate with a spelling error. There should be a vowel in between the X and the L, either an I or a Y, depending on your linguistic preference or cultural preference. We'll see later on that these things are in pest control products. And that's not going to be mentioned in this article, because this article is only dealing with an evaluation of pollutants in perfumes, colognes, and health effects on the consumer. Let's take a look at this abstract. Cosmetic products, especially perfumes and colognes, are widely used in various communities. However, the use of these products can have side effects on consumers. There's a bit of shifty grammar here, so not as bad as that in this Canola Tarda official thing, but we're going to have to use a bit of artistic license here as we read along. A whole bunch of numbers on how they selected articles yielded the results of the systemic study showed that phthalates, aldehydes, parabens, and aluminum-based salts are the most important contaminants in aromatic products that can cause side effects, such as allergies, breast cancer, reproductive disorders, especially in males, skin allergies, nervous system damage, and migraine headaches for consumers. The incidence of complications in people using these products depends on parameters such as age, sex, race, amount of substance consumed, duration of use, and economic status, or how much money they have in common parlance. And regarding the relationship between diseases such as cancer, respiratory disorders, and endocrine malfunctions with common contaminants in aromatic products, incidence of these diseases is probable in consumers, which require further research to prove. So in the end, they're leaving us with a choice. We can choose our poisons. Smells play a significant role in human behavior. A pleasant scent can have a calming effect, but an unpleasant odor can lead to anxiety and discomfort. And we're going to see throughout all this scientific mumbo-jumbo that the conclusion is the exact opposite. You're better off with unpleasant odors. Be that as it may, the first evidence of perfume use by humans dates back to thousands of years ago, when Egyptians used herbs, gums, and resins as aromatic compounds in their religious rites. Today, perfumes are used in various applications, including deodorants, laundry products, shampoos, and conditioners, cleansers, and a whole host of other unnamed products. These compounds include two groups, natural and synthetic. Natural perfumes are divided into categories. Doesn't really matter. They're aromatic compounds and musk, which are extracted from plants, lichen, seaweed, and special oil obtained from different parts of a plant. The other group is synthetic aromatic compounds, which are often used as alternative sources due to low production costs and problems related to low product quality or lack of resources. So in other words, fake is cheaper. Aromatic products contain a complex mixture of chemicals such as volatile organic compounds limonene, alpha pinene, beta pinene, ethanol, acetone, acetaldehyde, and a whole host of other magic potions. Phthalates such as diethylphthalate, dibutylphthalate, dimethylphthalate, and diisobutylphthalate in deodorants, shampoos, soaps, cosmetics, nail polishes, and parabens, among others. Methylparaben, butylparaben, ethylparaben, and propylparaben are used as fungicides, bactericides, and preservatives in cosmetics, perfumes, and deodorants. Diethylphthalate is a chemical used to make perfumes last longer. The U.S. Clean Water Act lists it as a toxic and priority pollutant. Dimethylphthalate and diethylphthalate lead to slower evaporation of perfume aromas, which results in longer persistence. Scientific evidence shows that 4 phthalates in 102 hairsprays, perfumes, fragrances, and nail polishes, dibutylphthalate in 19 of 21 nail polishes and 11 of 42 perfumes, as well as diethylphthalate in 24 of 42 perfumes and 208 aromatic substances were observed. Triclosan is an antimicrobial substance that was widely used in antibacterial hand soaps and was banned by the Food and Drug Administration in 2016, but is still used today in some compounds such as fragrances, toothpaste, mouthwash, and acne cream. Complications of using perfume include neuropathy, depression and autism, neoplasms, breast cancer and prostate cancer, effects on the liver, migraine headaches, asthma attacks, mucosal symptoms, watery or red eyes and sneezing, neurological problems, dizziness, convulsions, headache, fainting, imbalance, respiratory problems, cough, shortness of breath, skin problems such as rashes, urticaria, which is red spots on the skin, redness of the skin in general, skin tingling, dermatitis, immune system problems such as swollen lymph nodes, fever and fatigue, gastrointestinal tract problems such as nausea, bloating, and diarrhea, and cardiovascular problems such as rapid or irregular heartbeat, tremors, and chest discomfort. About 75% of people with shortness of breath have experienced asthma attacks caused by perfumes. Also, the risk of asthma and high IgE serum levels were increased in the children who were exposed to phthalates during pregnancy. Furthermore, there are some concerns about the effect of diethylphthalate on male fertility, so this group should avoid smelling like a flower or using perfume products that contain large amounts of diethylphthalate. Triclosan and some parabens have significant effect on the spread of cancer, and triclosan can disrupt thyroid function. The findings of a survey in the United States, Australia, and the United Kingdom indicated that on average, in all three countries, about 30% of people were exposed to at least one fragrance. Among many factors, aromatic compounds with estrogenic properties, such as parabens, phthalates, nitromusks, have been an important and main cause of breast cancer. These compounds penetrate the bloodstream through the skin and lead to impaired endocrine homeostasis. Studies on children in the age range of 5 to 15 years showed that the most common allergens in the development of dermatitis are paraben, potassium dichromate, and perfume. Look out for potassium dichromate in your soaps and deodorants. Many studies show that most perfumes, even in small amounts, can cause neurological disorders in the fetus of pregnant mothers. One of the causes of autism is exposure to chemicals, perfumes, and medications during pregnancy and after birth through breast milk. Studies show that aromatic products emit more than 100 volatile organic compounds, which can pose a serious threat to human health. The purpose of the study is a comprehensive review of different types of contaminants identified in these products and the adverse effects observed in people exposed to them. Attempts were also made to identify and categorize the incidence of complications in these individuals and the factors affecting the incidence and severity of complications. All right, so let's take a look here. Lots of data. Now, let's zip on over to the Great White North. Brought to you by the government, the mind control of Canola Tardistan. Learn about phthalates and if they're safe. They're missing a vowel. Missing a vowel here. How convenient. Phthalates are a large group of chemicals used in plastics to soften and increase flexibility. They're missing a vowel as well here, also used as solvents in household products. Examples of products containing phthalates include self-care products, such as cosmetics, non-prescription drugs, and supernatural health products. They're also found in construction and renovation products such as building materials, lubricants and greases, paints and coatings, adhesives, and sealants. We're going to see later on. Where is it? PVC keeps off PVC. So pay close attention to your household products that contain PVC, like your plumbing, plastic plumbing. They're also in fabrics and textiles, electrical items and electronics, and children's toys. They're at the bottom of the list. Children's toys and childcare articles. Phthalates may also be used in printing inks, automotive products, pest control products. So take a look at your insecticides. Some food packaging materials as well. So, what type of food packaging materials? All those plastic wraps and those plastic baggies. They don't tell us which ones. Up and around, wrapping up your food with these dangerous chemicals. You may be exposed to phthalates as a result of using these products. You may also be exposed to phthalates from indoor air, dust, water, and food. Wow, how can that be? Well, they're not going to tell us how these can come about, but you got to be wary, so connect your own dots. In general, we have found that most phthalates don't pose a risk to health or the environment at current levels of exposure. However, diethylhexyl phthalate is an exception. Diethylhexyl phthalate was found to be health toxic following an assessment in 1994. Our recent assessment has found that diethylhexyl phthalate is also toxic to the environment. What we're doing again, missing a vowel. Canada, whoever that is, took action following the 1994 assessment to limit Canada's exposure to diethylhexyl phthalate by banning its use in cosmetics. Managing its use in medical devices, so it's still out there, and only regulating its use in the vinyl in children's toys and child care articles. They're at the bottom of the list. If levels of exposure to phthalates increase, some phthalates could pose a risk to our health and our environment. Canada, whoever that is, will continue to monitor new information on phthalate exposure. Take action as necessary. An incomplete sentence at the bottom of the list. How convenient. Again, what you can do. You can minimize your exposure to diethylhexyl phthalate. Use these tips. Read product labels and the manufacturer's directions. So, if your product does not have an ingredients list, take a guess. They don't want you to know what's in it. Choose products labeled as phthalate or polyvinyl chloride free. Be aware that some soft or flexible plastic products made with polyvinyl chloride may contain phthalates. Check for the Plastic Recycling Code 3, which identifies polyvinyl chloride products. Contact the manufacturer if you're missing a vowel again, unsure if your product contains phthalates or polyvinyl chloride. Diethylhexyl phthalate may be listed on labels using the full name, or it may not. Di-2-ethylhexyl missing vowel phthalate. Follow safety warnings and directions. Use, store, and dispose of the products safely. And last but not least, what you can do is keep away from children. Use these tips. Keep away from children. Keep soft polyvinyl chloride items not intended for children out of reach. Don't let a child suck or chew on soft plastic products that aren't weren't missing a vowel intended for children. Well, thank you. And for
more
more information, you can
click on all.